that, each one of these individuals that you're going to see in interleague competition has already qualified as a full pole distance. Like we said, we are moving to a floating finish, 310 feet. They have no option. In other words, we have no test puller here in interleague pull-off. They have two tries to make 75 feet, as any normal pole would be. They have two tries to cross 75. Scott Doty, our starting flagman, bump in at the finish. Let's see what Randy Brown can get done. Comes out of Region 2, Venco, Minnesota, or Region 3, rather. Region 3 is Chad Christensen's home region. Squares up on the sled, everything squared away, gets the green flag from Scott Doty. Remember, we got a 293 and 3 laid down.
Right there.
competition right here on the track. Mr. David Banner, Donald LaFontaine and Deanna. Vanderbilt, Banner designed, and Banner driven. Mr. Chevrolet himself, we're talking about David Banner. He's won this interleague competition five times over the course of a competition right here. Now, the interleague was first held in Columbus in 1987. It was moved out here to Fort Recovery in 1991. Grand National competitor from the word go, David Banner, Paul Fontaine, and Indiana. Competition. Tom Martin out of Bonnie, Illinois. We talk about the placings that they are in the points. And points are very important as they work their way through the season. Each competition they run gives them the opportunity to accumulate points. And that's just exactly what has happened in this particular instance. These individuals getting here through the interleague pull-off have accumulated points throughout the season. Carrying an interleague decal on the side or on the machine someplace with some contestants for interleague pull-off points. And that's what's happened all summer long. John Martin qualified as the number two spot. He elected to pull in the number three spot for competition tonight out of top five. 1,000th of a foot separating places right now. We were talking about Unlimited a while ago in a shoot-off and a shoot-off competition, and right here we see it. David Banner comes out. David Banner comes out having made a full pull. Rob Martin also with a full pull. We have added 1 week. The Whiskey Eliminator transfer box, the weight transfer box, that portion of the sled that moves front to back, or back to front, actually, is competition. Steve Klingenberg going to end up in third place. Wayne Garrett in fourth place. And fifth place.
Between the two engines.
0.0273.0 for Jeff Justice. We are now down to four competitors in the class. We've got three of them out the door. Rich Rusty, the Silver Bullet out of 84, Pennsylvania. Out of Lenox, Iowa, the workhorse of Rob Russell. And Terry Blackmore, not Snow Ride, out of Schaumburg, Wisconsin.
Region 4 competitor right here.
Kind of sign 2.
Dale Burleson. Will make his shot down the track. Ahead of Tony Martin out of Batavia, Illinois, which will round out our regional qualifiers for the modified. Dale Burleson. Albemarle, North Carolina. 288 even, led down by Wayne and Creek.
Hometown, the green comes out.
every heartbeat. Good looking machine, 1994 Chevrolet. Watch this one also run Bank of Missouri as well.
You know, I've got to make this comment about the four-wheel drive division. But right now, if I'm not mistaken, it's 1 or 2 points separating, 2 points separating first and second place.
Proof of that. The Fort Play Machine, Wauseon, Ohio.